Your Honor, Roy Hobbs is here to see you.
Thanks, Alex.
Nice of you to come, Mr. Hobbs.
Of course. It's my pleasure. Nice looking office you got here. A bit dark for my liking.
Well, as a youngster, I would wake up sobbing in the middle of the night in the dark.
Why are you laughing?
As you'll observe, I disciplined myself against that fear, and now I much prefer a dark-lit room. There is, in the darkness, a unity that, if you will, cannot be achieved in any other environment. A blending of self with what the self perceives, an exquisite mystical experience. I one day intend to, at this position on the harmony of darkness, can evil exist in harmony. It may profit you to ponder the thought, Mr. Hobbs.
All I know about the dark is that you can't see anything.
Can you see me?
Maybe I can. Maybe I can't.
I guess you know why you're here.
No, I don't. You tell me.
I'm impressed with your performance. I know what you've been doing to the ball both here and on the road. And some papers I've been writing that I'm developing a new contract for you.
What'd you have in mind?
My mucha miss force turns have been reversed by our success. Stands have been constantly filled. Are you not fascinated by the almighty dollar?
I never give it much thought.
Are you above such mundane thoughts, Mr. Hobbs?
I didn't say that.
I'm not going to let good deeds go unrewarded, Mr. Hobbs. I believe a new contract is in order for more money.
If you want to pay me more money, that's up to you.
I don't need any gratitude on your part, Mr. Hobbs. I am under no legal obligation to pay you one penny more.
I play to win.
A man your age should be thinking about his future.
Well, let me put it to you this way. Okay, there is no way in hell I'm gonna let you steal the team from Pop. Pop.
The fact is, Pops is a jinxed man, and you and all the other Roy Hobbs in the world aren't gonna change that.
You come back here and turn off that infernal light!
Thank you.